These youngsters are celebrating a Supreme Court decision that upheld their protected status and rights in the United States.
I've had DACA since I was 15, 16 years old. It's allowed me to go to college. It's allowed me to get a full-time job. That could have all been stripped away.
The so-called Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals program was created by former President Barack Obama in 2012. But for years, President Trump has vowed to repeal the program as part of his hardline immigration policy. Local courts have since prevented the move as unlawful, a decision that's now being upheld by the Supreme Court on a 5-4 vote.
I'm elated. I am really affirmed that the movement of young people organizing 11 million undocumented people demanding exactly what we deserve, we win. And so I'm honored to be here today at the Supreme Court and ready to keep fighting for more.
President Trump lashed out against the decision on Twitter, calling it politically motivated and seemingly not based on the law. Despite the major political setback, the president claims it gives him more power than ever anticipated. His opponents hailed the decision as a victory.
I cried tears of joy a few minutes ago when I heard the decision of the Supreme Court on DACA. These wonderful DACA kids and their families have a huge burden lifted off their shoulders. They don't have to worry about being deported. They can do their jobs. And I do believe this, someday soon, they will be American citizens.
Also known as Dreamers, roughly 1.9 million people participated in the program and embraced the U.S. as their only home. And throughout the pandemic, some have also become the only hope for their families.
People like myself, who have now become sole providers for a lot of our family, are left without employment, income, and also healthcare benefits.
Many DACA recipients provide livelihoods for their parents who may be undocumented, but they continue to be targets of the president during this re-election campaign. It is Tianshan, CGTN, Los Angeles.